Never you stop, but Penny and the Jets. I'm so sweet and wonderful.
Thank you. Good evening, New York. And welcome to the Farewell Yellow Brick Road Tour. And I had a problem putting the set list together because there were so many songs to choose from, and I chose the one that I thought worked best live and that I love playing over the years. So if I have left one of your favorites off, please excuse me, okay? Anyway, this song comes from the album Too Low for Zero. This next song comes from the second album that I made, and it was called Elton John, and it was the album that broke me as an artist, and it broke me here in America first. This is where it all started, so thank you so much. And the song that I'm going to play came out, was the first single on the album, and it, after the album was out 6 months, we had, Bernie and I had a phone call from our music publisher to say, you know what, someone else has covered this song. And we went, wow, because when you're young songwriters, anybody covering your song is fantastic. It could be the Chipmunks or Lawrence Welk. It didn't matter. It was a compliment and we were excited. So we said, well, who is it? And they said, well, it's Aretha Franklin. I can't remember what happened. Either I passed out or something. Can you imagine when you're two young kids songwriting, just about to launch a career, and someone as incredible as Aretha Franklin records your song? Oh, my God. It was one of the most stimulating moments of my early career, and I'm sure Bernie's as well. And I'm going to play the song right now. Blue Jean Baby, L.A. Lady, Simpsons for the band, Pretty Eyed, Pirate Smile. Montezina dancing in the sand. Now it's eating me up where with me, tiny dancing in my hand. Thank you so much. Thank you. I have been writing with my lyricist partner, Dave, Bernie Taupin, for 50 years. And it's a relationship that I'm so proud of because both personally and professionally, over those 50 years, we've grown closer together. And to the point now that we couldn't love each other more than we do. And I think that's a huge testament because in this business, people fall out with each other all the time over the most stupid things, jealousy, envy, success. And I love him dearly. And it's just probably the longest relationship that I've had with a friend for the whole of my life. And it's just so beautiful. And the way we write songs is quite unusual. From the very word go, he's given me a lyric on a piece of paper. I take it away into a room with a piano, and I sit there and I read the title, and then I read the lyric through. And because he's such a great storyteller, a little movie starts to appear in my head, and I kind of decide what kind of tempo the song would be, what kind of genre it might be. And it's like when you're a little kid and you first started to read and you picked up Huckleberry Finn or Moby Dick or whatever, and when you started reading it, your head was full of images and it was so wonderful. That's the way it happens with him. And this next song, he gave me the lyric. This is a 2.5 hour movie. What am I gonna do? Well, I worked at it because I love the lyric so much. And it tells of the demise of the Native American Red Indian. And the song is from the album Madman Across the Water. As I awoke this evening with the smell of wood smoke clinging, like a gentle cobweb hanging upon a painted teepee. Oh, I went to see my chieftain with my war lance and my woman, for he told her that the yellow moon would very soon be leaving. This I can't believe, I said, I can't believe our war lord's dead. We would not leave the chosen ones to the buzzards and the soldiers' guns. Oh, great father of the Iroquois, ever since I was young, I've read the writing of the smoke and breastfed on the sound of drums. I've learned to hurl the tomahawk and ride a painted pony wild, to run the gauntlet out the Sioux, to make a chieftain's daughter mine. Now you want that I should watch the red man's race be slowly crushed. What kind of word are these to hear from yellow dog, whom white man fear? Watching only what is mine, Lord. My pony, my score, and my child. I can't stay to see you die, along with my trapped pride. A girl to search for the yellow moon and the fathers of our sons.
the red sun sinks in the hills of gold and the healing waters run. Trampling down the prairie rose, even hoof tracks in the sand. Those wish to follow me are welcome with my hands. I heard from passing renegades, Geronimo's dead. He's been laying down his weapons when they filled him full of lead. I should carry on in this land that once was my land. I can't find a home. It's lonely and it's quiet, and all horse soldiers are coming. And I think it's time I strung my bow and cease my senses running. For soon I find the yellow moon alone. My loved ones, where the buffaloes graze in the clover fields without the sound of gun. And the red sun sinks left into the hills of gold, and peace to this young warrior comes with a bullet hole. She packed my bags last night, pre-flight. 0 hour 9 a.m. I'm gonna be high as a kite by then. I miss the earth so much. I'm missing my wife. It's lonely out in space. I'm such a timeless fly. to raise the kids. In fact, it's cold as hell, and there's no man to raise them. If you did, and all the science I don't understand.
Oh,
If you feel that it's real, I'm on trial, and I'm here in your prison. Like a coin, any man, I am Dante, and I'm fed with our treason.
One of my favorite Elton albums is Captain Fantastic and the Burned Out Cowboy. The Burned Out Cowboy. Because all the songs are about the struggle that Bernie and I had when we were trying to make it as fledgling songwriters, and all the walls we ran into, and all the disappointments we encountered. And this song is probably one of the most personal on the album.
When I think of those eastern lights, mugging nights, the curtains drawn, and the little room downstairs, We've done a lot, you really should have been there. Sitting like a princess first in her electric chair. I just want more beat, and I don't hear you anymore. We've all gone crazy lately. My friends out there rolling around the basement floor. Someone saved my life tonight, sugar bear. You almost had your hooks in me, didn't you, dear? You nearly had me roped and tied. All the bound, hypnotized, sweet freedom whispered in my ear, you're a butterfly. Butterflies are free to fly. Fly away, high away, bye-bye. Never realized the passing hours of even showers or slip noose hanging in my darkest dreams. I sang with my heart as souls of things, just up on a play by dominating queen. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. Sugar. leave our worlds woven like a crown. He calls a child Jesus, Catholic's the name, and I send him to the finest school in town. Leave on like some money. He makes a lot to say. He spends a day countdown in a garage by the motorway. He would buy a pump to a pump on a Christmas day when the New York Times said God is dead. And what we got as a topic ends on today. And I'm sorry, leave on. And I'm sorry, good and bad. And I'm sorry, leave on. Shabbat! Goodbye, Norma Jean. Though I never knew at all, you had the grace to hold yourself while those around you crawl out of the woodwork, and they whispered into your brain. I said, you on the treadmill, and they made you change your name. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would have liked to know you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before your legend ever did. Loneliness was tough, the toughest role you ever played. Hollywood created a superstar and pain was the price you paid. And even when you died, oh, the press still hounded you. All the papers had to say was that Marilyn was found in the nude. It seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would like to have known you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before your legend ever did. Goodbye, Norma Jean. Though I never knew you at all, you had the grace to hold yourself while those around you crawl. Goodbye, Norma Jean. From a young man in the 22nd row, who sees you as something more than sexy, more than just a Marilyn Monroe. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would have liked to have known you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before your legend ever did. I would have liked to have known you, oh, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before your legend ever I'm You tell me there's an angel in your tree. Did it say it's come to call on me? Well, things are getting desperate in our home. Living in the Paris of the restless folk I know. Everybody now, bring your family down to the riverside. Let to the institute work here, the fast dog a high. The high for what I've done, the rich man is free. Time to put flame torch to this.
In 1990, I had an epiphany. My life was really bad. I was at rock bottom. I was a drug addict, everything you can name it. I'd lost all sense of value. And so I decided to ask for help, which took me a long time to do. And I got sober and clean. And there's a few people in the audience tonight that can remember when I wasn't sober and clean. Anyway, I wanted to put things in my life back in balance. I wanted to get up in the morning and feel happy and open the curtains and look at the day instead of closing the curtains and wanting to be alone. I felt guilty that I hadn't done enough to address the AIDS epidemic during the 1980s. And so from my kitchen table in Atlanta, I set up the Elton John AIDS Foundation. Never in my wildest dreams could I have imagined how much it would grow in stature and how far we would come in the treatment of HIV and AIDS. I truly believe in my lifetime that I will see an end to this disease, this pandemic, which has killed millions and millions and millions of people. But I have hope. And one thing I've learned as I get older, and boy, am I getting older, it's about the extraordinary healing power of hope, compassion, and love. And at the moment, wherever I go in the world, there's not much compassion, and there's not much love. There's a lot of meanness, mean-spiritedness, and I hate it. As a musician, I'm used to bringing people together. And music does that. It doesn't matter what religion, what political party you are. You come here, you have a good time. And I truly believe that love is the cure for what ails us at the moment. And we need to be nicer to each other, starting as soon as possible. This song, Believe, says it all. This next song is one of my favorites, but when Bernie gave me the original lyric, I read it through and I thought it was a little long. So I decided to cross out the last verse, and I did. And the last verse explained the meaning of the whole song. So throughout the years, people have regarded it as a bit of an enigma as to what the song was about. And so for those of you who don't know, there's a wonderful David LaChapelle film coming up, and the song is called Daniel.
Says that the best place he's ever seen.
Thank you. Now, I've been touring for 50 years, and it's been the most unbelievable journey. When I started out as a songwriter with Bernie, nobody covered our songs, so we wrote songs for ourselves, and then I recorded them. And in those days, to sell records, you had to get a band and go on the road. So I got a band and I went on the road. And it all happened kind of accidentally. And if you'd have told me back in 1969 that I would be sitting here in 2018 telling you this story, I said, you're crazy. So it's been the most beautiful and wonderful trip. And there's been one constant thing throughout the journey. You people out there. You bought the 45, the albums, the 8 tracks, the cassettes, the CDs, the DVDs, the merchandise. But most of all, and most importantly to me, you bought and you buy the tickets to the show. Because as much as I love to write songs and go in the studio and record them and make records, the greatest thing that a musician can have is a rapport with another human being from the stage. And I will miss you so much. But having said that, I have a million memories, a trillion memories, and enough applause to last me a million lifetimes. But I want to thank you, because you made this journey possible, and you have no idea how much you've given to me with your love, your loyalty, and your generosity. Thank you so much. Life has a way of throwing curveballs at you, and about 8 years ago, my little first curveball arrived, and then 6 years ago, my other curveball arrived, and it's about them now, and I've had so much fun making music, and I still make music, but I just have to stay home now and enjoy the rest of my life with my family. So it's more important. The journey would not have been as wonderful without every single musician that I've played with on record and on stage. And this band that I have now is probably the finest band I've ever assembled on stage. And I'm going to introduce them one by one, and you're going to give them a big Madison Square Garden roar. On the right-hand side of the stage, on percussion, vocals, and drums, John Mahon. On keyboards, Kim Ballard. On bass guitar and vocals, Matt Bissonette. One of the greatest musicians I've ever played with, one of the most incredible men I've ever met. He's been in and out of the band since 1974. In 1979, we went around the world a percussion player and a vocalist and a piano player. And we had the best time. And I'm so glad that he's with us for the final journey on this tour. He's played with everybody there is to play with who's worth their salt as a musician, both on stage and on record. On percussion, the amazing Ray Cooper! In 1969, when I started the band, I had the late, great Dean Murray on bass guitar and vocals, and this guy on drums and vocals, and he started the journey, and he's finishing the journey. And I'm so happy because he's the engine room of the band, and he's playing and singing, quite honestly, better than he's ever done. I'm so proud that I still have him in the band. On drums and vocals, the incredible Nigel Olsen! And last but not least, I wanted to add another instrument to the three-piece, and I wanted to add a guitar. So I asked my record producer, Gus Dalton, if he knew any great young electric guitarists, and he said, actually, I don't, but I do know a wonderful folk musician who plays acoustic guitar, mandolin, and banjo. And I listened to David's work with his band Magna Carta, and I said, well, he's too good to turn down. I don't care if he doesn't play electric guitar. And he picked up an electric guitar on the Honky Chateau album when he joined us, and he's never left, never looked back since. He's our wonderful band leader. I couldn't do without him. And he's just an amazing musician and a wonderful man. And he has a birthday today. Happy birthday, Dave. He's 9 years old. On guitar and vocals from Edinburgh in Scotland, the fabulous David Johnston.
Down on me.
Bye.
Georgia, the Dodger had so much fun. Holding hands and swimming thought.
Get out!
Thank you, New York. You've been amazing as usual. It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy you a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no, or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. Well, my gift and my song, and this one's for you. And you can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is. Well, you're in the world. Well, a few of the first sailors, oh, they got me quite proud. But the sun's been quite kind. Well, I wrote that song. Oh, it's for people like you that keep it turned on. So excuse me for getting, but these things I do. I forgot if they're green or they're blue. Anyway, the thing, what I really mean, oh, you're not the sweetest dye I've ever seen. You can tell everybody this is yours. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is. Well, you're in the world. Hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words wonderful life is. Well, you're in the world. That's your song. Okay, you can sing on this one.
When are you gonna come down? When are you going to lie? You should have stayed on the farm. Should have listened to my old man. You know you can't help me forever. Didn't sign up for you. Not a present for your friends who old them. This boy is too young to be singing the blues. Oh, 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 oh. So goodbye, yellow brick road. you'll do that. I'll bet they shoot down your plane. It'll take you a couple of vodka and tonic to set you on your feet again.